I recognize the senator from the 53rd.
Thank you, Mr. President. Heard a lot about courage and conviction from the previous speaker. Majority Leader referenced fierce independence. Well, I reckon the speaker and myself come from a similar bloodline. Because, senators, I rise today in a steadfast opposition to Senate Resolution 687. My fellow senators, I think to bring a comparison to who this man was, we should first look at one of the greatest Georgians to ever live. A man who is globally recognized as a symbol of justice. Who am I talking about? Martin Luther King Jr. A man, what did he say? He said an injustice anywhere was a threat to justice everywhere. Powerful words that we should think about as we vote for this resolution. Because this body is about to perpetually memorialize, in my opinion, one of the most corrupt Georgia leaders we'll ever see in our lifetimes. I first remember learning about a girl named Haley when I served in the chamber across the way. Haley was brutally raped, sodomized in her living room by a man her family trusted. That man was Jason Brothers, and he hired Speaker David Ralston as his attorney, not to defend him, but to protect him from justice. You see, for nearly a decade, this case rocked on, and Haley became terminally ill, never seeing justice. Her family once walked in on her in a bathtub with blood as she contemplated suicide. And you probably say, Senator, well, that's just one case. Where can you go with that? But no, there were several more. There was a case of a lady who lost her daughter in her arms as she bled out because a man was driving drunk. Destroyed the woman's family. But she wasn't able to get justice because the man charged with the DUI hired Speaker David Ralston as his attorney. You see, there was a man named Derek Key who for 10 years delayed cases after molesting a 14-year-old child, being protected by David Ralston. Now, how did David Ralston do this? We heard about him being chairman of Judiciary Non-Civil. Well, back in 2006, there was a bill called Senate Bill 503. The man created the legislative leave and then profited off of it, making hundreds of thousands of dollars protecting people from justice. You see, the truth is hard to hear.
Senator,
Mr. President,
we got decorum, you know, rules here in this chamber. I think you've made your point, sir. So if you could just go ahead and wrap up, we'd be appreciative.
Mr. President, I know it's hard to hear, but there were thousands of case delays. And make no mistake, these egregious examples I've given is no semblance of morality. You see, we as lawmakers are supposed to protect the vulnerable, Mr. President. We're supposed to protect children. We're supposed to protect law enforcement officers. Think about the law enforcement officers who were assaulted and weren't able to get to justice because of this man. You see, the speaker turned a blind eye to what we as legislators know to be truth. And records show that after he was speaker, he did not attend another court case. You see, he had more than 164 clients, because if you're not trying those clients, you just pick up more and more of them. No court, less work. He had an operation. He was running an industry, Mr. President, and all he was using was a simple form letter, sending it to the court, referencing the code section that the man created in 2006.
Senator, not the time or place. Not the time or place.
Mr. President.
Go ahead and yield the will, Senator.
At your request.
Thank you, Senator.